one of the crowd favorites is the Tesla-powered Porsche 912.
We've been doing EV conversions for 10, 15 years, and still, if I tell someone what they do, they're just like, didn't even know it was possible. Didn't even know it existed.
As countries around the world race to meet decarbonization targets, electric vehicles, also known as EVs, are selling at record highs. But by replacing grease and gas with code and batteries, yesterday's mechanics need to become the EV technicians of tomorrow.
This is the whole motor section here.
It would behoove someone, if they're thinking about making that change, to kind of think about it quickly, because it's gonna be a lot of demand really fast.
Take me to the market, Mr. David.
It's fascinating to be in this as there's this shift happening, because you feel like you're a little part of history.
Once again, technology is changing work as we know it. Are you ready? These are the blue, white, and no-collar jobs of today and the future.
All right, here we are at Zelectric. This is the front office of Zelectric, and in back you see all these fine German cars. This is where I spend about 2-3 days a week just helping with the conversion process, training people, doing hands-on labor, and even some CAD design stuff.
You've probably never seen an auto shop quite like this one. It specializes in converting classic gas-powered cars into electric vehicles, making Trent Wansley a rare breed of mechanic.
I went to school to be a mechanical engineer and have always been just fascinated with cars. I would say professionally, I've been doing conversions and electric powertrain stuff for 8 years. People want that electric drivetrain, but in something that's very unique.
There's a good chance over the past year, you've been noticing more and more EVs on the road. In 2021, EV sales grew by 85% in the US. While these classic car conversions are a bit niche, it gives us a window into what the future of auto repair shops will look like.
Right now, I need to solder in a resistor across what's called the CAN bus network. Being an EV tech is a lot cleaner. You're not dealing with as much grease and fluids and fumes and all those things.
Electric vehicles also have a lot less parts. Tesla's drivetrain has about 17 parts, whereas most gas-powered cars have about 200.
See what some of the hard data looks like coming through here?
But their complexities lie in the software and the battery system.
We're not adding a lot of complexity to these cars, but if you accidentally touch a couple big cables together, you could absolutely kill a $20,000 battery pack.
We'll say a little minor fire.
There's really good financial stability in the EV market as a technician.
Though you may need some extra electrical education, currently an EV tech in California can make up to $75,000 per year.
When I got out of school and started doing this thing, there was no handbook to converting EVs.
Every single car that we do, we try to make steps so the next one is easier, quicker to assemble, less wiring, more simple. We're getting closer to where it's accessible for everyone.
The history of this car, I kind of started building it 8 years ago. From there, I've just been iterating this car constantly, and that means going from a gas engine to an electric motor, which is a Tesla motor in back out of a Model S.
What's gonna really explode the EV technician industry, I think, is just the oncoming of bigger market share of EVs out of all cars. You're gonna need automotive shops that work on EVs specifically, and there's not a lot of trained technicians out there at the moment.
For example, a recent study in the UK revealed that only 11% of their mechanics were qualified to work on EVs.
A lot of shops don't take on that work because it's still a little bit mysterious. So what I do is a lot of education and some training.
Hey, Kurt, what's up? So this is Kurt. He's kind of getting trained up right now for some of the EV technician stuff.
Anyone that has any kind of background mechanical is already so well set up to do this.
A typical path towards becoming an EV technician includes completing a certificate program at a vocational or trade school, followed by an internship to get hands-on experience before attaining full-time employment.
All these get tapped M6, and then we just run the bolts through the lid.
We need more people, more workforce, to kind of attack all the demand. You can always take your car to a dealer, but people are gonna want competitive rates. So that's where it'll be a serious industry. You gotta innovate every day. all of us are kind of trying to share, get problems solved, and move the industry forward. This is just going to keep growing.
There is a long history of people tinkering with electric cars. And more recently, the price of the technology that powers them has gone way down.
So now you have more people that want to get into it.
The United States set a goal to make 50% of all new car sales electric by 2030, sending a clear signal that the automotive industry is entering into a new era.
I like being on the bleeding edge of the development of this technology. It happened a little faster than I thought it would. The development is just going so fast, and we're seeing it. We're seeing the uptake every single day. It's almost exponential.